Just a little windy. I'm sure the audio is fine. It's a little bit too windy. The audio's not fine.
All right, so today's gonna be fun because we're gonna check out this amazing zoom lens, the Tamron 35 to 150 millimeter standard zoom lens. It's probably the best zoom lens that I've ever used, but we're gonna check it out. We're gonna do some real world testing. Sorry, it's just so windy. Why? It's blowing me back.
This video is sponsored by Professional Photographers of America, or PPA, and I've mentioned them plenty of times throughout my videos because they're such a great resource for photographers who run a business. I've also mentioned that their signature conference and expo, Imaging USA, is just around the corner and will be happening January 16th and 18th, 2022, and yours truly will be there. Imaging USA is one of the largest and longest running photography conferences and expo, and will be held at the very beautiful National Harbor in Maryland. I've actually never been before, so super, super excited to be there. But what if I told you that you can go to the expo for free? Yep, thanks to PPA, you can score a free pass to check out the expo, which has 50,000 square feet of pure photography inspiration. There's gonna be 100 plus exhibitors featuring the latest photography services and products. You'll get to check out product demos to improve on your photography. Of course, you'll check out the photography exhibits, including the work of former White House photographer Pete Souza, so that's cool. There'll also be many educational sessions to give you tips and advice for your business and craft, and you get all this at no cost to you. Thanks to me. Well, thanks to PPA, but a little bit of me. Well, not really me. It's all PPA. And if you want more, you can join PPA right now, and you can go to Imaging USA for free for your first year membership. So make sure to click the link in the description below to get your free ticket to the hottest photography expo of 2022, or join PPA and you can go to the entire event absolutely for free, and maybe I'll see you there. I'll probably be where the food's at. Yeah, that's where I'll be. So all that was shot entirely on the A7S III and the Tamron 35 to 150 zoom lens. Here it is. Here it is in all its glory, and it's a pretty big lens. Like, look at that big mama jama. That's really heavy. Now, the reason why I really wanted to check out this lens, well, for one, the zoom range. Like, the focal range of this lens is insane, and it's something that us content creators just long for. I mean, you're going from 35 millimeters all the way to 150 millimeters. Most standard zoom lens start at 24 millimeters and go to just 70, which is totally fine and covers all the classic focal lengths for a wide shot, a medium shot, and a telephoto shot. And typically when you're investing in lenses, you start off with a standard zoom lens like a 24 to 70, and then maybe you wanna go with a wide angle lens like a 16 to 35, and then after that you wanna go for a telephoto zoom lens like a 70 to 200 millimeter. But with a 16 to 35 and the standard zoom lens, there's an overlap of focal lengths. Like, you have a 16 to 35, and then you have 24 to 70. And so there is a focal length gap, which makes you wonder, should a standard zoom lens start at 35 and then go up? Well, the answer is here. It's the Tamron 35 to 150. Like, if I decide to get this lens, like, this would pair perfectly with my Sony 16 to 35 G Master lens. So now I have a focal length of 16 millimeters going to 35, and with the Tamron, I have 35 millimeters going to 150, which almost kind of negates the need for me to get a 70 to 200 telephoto zoom lens, you know what I mean? Like, with my wide angle lens and this lens combined, like, that kind of covers pretty much all the focal lengths that you could possibly need for any given shoot. I mean, of course, those are specialty lenses like prime lenses or a super telephoto zoom lens, but for most projects, going from 16 to 150 millimeters is plenty. Plenty.
So windy that it knocked over my tripod. What the heck, man? Ah, Texas. Why can't you just be chill, man?
All right, so now let's talk specifics about this lens. The Tamron 35 to 150 millimeter lens is designed specifically for Sony E-mount cameras. It has a variable f-stop going from f2 to 2.8, which to me, I think is totally insane to have a zoom lens with this range. I mean, most standard zoom lenses have a constant f2.8, which is great. And this lens has f2.8 capabilities as well. But at 35 millimeters, you can go all the way down to f2. F2! It almost sounds like I'm saying FU, but it's F2. The build quality of the lens is really good. Like, it definitely doesn't feel cheap by any means. It's weather sealed, or at least mostly weather sealed. Like, there's a rubber gasket in the back, and even the USB-C port is weather sealed. And so, yeah, that's nice to know. Oh, and speaking of the USB-C ports, like, you can update the firmware of this lens as well as assign different functions to the custom buttons throughout the lens. That's crazy to me, but yeah, there you go. USB-C port right there. Of course, you've got your autofocus, manual focus switch. You have your zoom lock button over here. The focus ring is incredibly smooth. And then you have the zoom ring, which has a nice friction to it. Like, it doesn't feel like I'm pushing the lens too far if I need the zoom out all the way. Like, it feels like I can do a nice smooth zoom if I'm zooming manually. And so yeah, I actually quite like that. Yeah, it's very nice. And then internally, similar to a lot of the newer Sony lenses, there is a linear motor focusing system instead of that rotating lens focusing thing. What are they called? They call it VXD, Voice Coil Extreme Torque Drive. Essentially a linear motor focusing system, very similar to the newer Sony lenses. So in other words, autofocusing is fast and quiet. I will say though, that there is a bit of hunting when you're trying to autofocus at night. A little bit of photography, but really more so in video, at least in my experience. But when the lighting conditions are right, then autofocus is a beast with the Tamron 35 to 150. And then lastly, the filter thread of this bad boy is 82 millimeters. This lens is definitely not cheap as well. I mean, it's gonna run you $1,899 US, but at the same time, my 16 to 35G master lens costs over $2,000. And so comparing prices, this actually seems pretty reasonable, especially with the focal range that this lens provides. And so yeah, I think the price is fair. All right, so we got the A7S III. We have the Tamron 35 to 150. Place it on my tripod, and yeah, I'm just gonna do some real world testing with it, take some photos, shoot some videos, and really kind of show you the range that this lens is capable of. It's a pretty dang cool lens. Here we go. And look at that. That's cool. Well, that's nice. Sound effects were not necessary. Well, no, they were totally necessary. I'm gonna zoom back out at 35. And gotta say, the zoom range is really good, but also zooming is actually really smooth on the Tamron lens. That's really nice. All right, so there is a flag. You probably don't see it in the wide shot, but there is an American flag over there yonder, and we're going to zoom in. Right now we are at 35 millimeters on the Tamron lens, and let's go ahead and zoom now. 3, 2, 1, here we go. There we go, very nice. All right, I'm gonna zoom out. And we're gonna zoom in. Very cool. And just for kicks and giggles, I'm gonna do clear image zoom, meaning I can zoom in even more because it's the A7S III. So here we go. Ah, very nice. Man, this lens can go a long way. That's really cool. Now, mind you, I am using the A7S III. It's a full frame 12 megapixel camera, so I'm not doing any favors by giving any advantages to the Tamron 35 to 150 millimeter lens. If anything, it's a disadvantage because it's 12 megapixels. If I had a camera like the A7 IV, then oh, it's a little bit of a different story. But again, for this video, I just wanted to show you the capabilities and the zoom range of this lens. Not so much the audio though. Audio is gonna suck for this video. All right, well, that's the video, and this is the lens. Still windy. But if you wanna check out this lens, links will be down below. Huge thanks again to PPA for sponsoring this video. Again, if you want a free pass to the expo, then links will be down below for all those details. But that's it, I'm out of here. I don't know what else to film here because it's so gosh darn windy. Ah, Texas, you got no chill. You got no chill, man. All right, guys, I'm out, see ya.